34 tells us, I will exalt the Lord at all times. His praises will always be on my lips. My soul will boast in the Lord. Let the afflicted hear and rejoice. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. As Christians, followers of Lord Jesus Christ, week after week, we come together, even the day after day, we come together to exalt our risen Lord.
Amen.
Magnify him, bring glory to his name. And one of the things we do, one of the way we do this is coming together with other believers. On Sundays, we are in the church with other believers. We do worship our crucified and risen Lord.
Amen.
But some of you who follow the side media, small media, which no one even mentions about it, probably heard what is happening to our brothers and sisters in Muslim majority countries, especially in Algeria. Our brothers and sisters in Algeria are being persecuted. One third of the church is being shut down because Christian people are the ones who are worshiping in these churches. One third of the church in Algeria is shut down. Pastors are being dragged, persecuted, beaten by the government because in Muslim majority countries, freedom of belief, freedom of worship is not exist. If you are Christian, that is your crime. Your crime is to be Christian. Your crime is to be willing to glorify Lord Jesus Christ in group gathering. Sadly, in Algeria as well as in many Muslim countries, this is difficult to practice. Our brothers and sisters are being persecuted. A church which has the congregation of 700 people is shut down. Another church, 500 congregation, is shut down. One third of the churches, one third of the Christian worship places are being shut down because it is being criminal and being Christian same in lots of Muslim majority countries. And in Algeria, government steps in and then shuts down the churches.
So says the Algerian government shut down three churches this week, this was last month, including the two biggest congregations in Northern Africa. Authorities forced Christians from their buildings and arrested some who continued to protest their crackdown. Members of the large Protestant congregation in Algeria, the 700-member Church of the Gospel, in Tizi Ouza, were warned their church would be sealed. So we are concerned about our brothers and sisters in Algeria, and we know that Islam teaches to completely destroy those who oppose the ways of Allah. In Surah 9:29, it says kill, not fight. The Arabic is kill those who don't believe in Allah, including the people of the book, which are Christians and Jews. And we are concerned for our brothers and sisters, but as my sister read in Psalm 34, that we will praise the Lord at all times. And Jesus in the New Testament, in John 16, he said, you will have many troubles in this world. Many troubles will come to you, but be of good cheer because I have overcome the world. We know it's difficult to be of good cheer in times of trouble, but Jesus is with you. This world will pass away. We will live for eternity with Christ. That is the main goal. But in this world, we will have troubles here and there. We just have to endure up to the end.
It is, actually, we are not surprised because we look at life of our Lord, risen Lord Jesus Christ. We see he was persecuted.
Yeah, he suffered.
He was mocked. He died on the cross.
Yeah.
Yet he was able to forgive those who persecute him. One of the things Christian scripture teaches is we must love everyone. We must pray for those who persecute us.
Exactly.
We must forgive them. That's Christian scripture teaches. But we want people to know, while media is silent, Sky, BBC, all our big media is silent, God knows and hears, and concern for our brothers and sisters who are suffering in the world because of their faith. It's not because they killed someone. It's not they because stole something. Their crime is to follow and choose to worship Lord Jesus Christ.
That's and it. As they Daniel didn't do anything
said, yeah,
else.
That is their crime. But when Islam comes and dominates, takes your freedom of belief away, takes your freedom of worship away. But as those of you who are watching us, brothers and sisters, please, pray for faiths of our brothers and sisters around the world who are being persecuted because of their faith, that they can be able to hold on our risen Lord.
Islam only exists when there is fear and oppression. Through fear and oppression, Islam can exist. Our faith does not need fear. The Bible says perfect love casts out fear, and God is love. And when we are following God, we're following love. We don't follow fear. We're not with God because we are fearful because he's going to kill us or something, because we love him. Islam thrives on fear and oppression. If people can leave Islam and you're not killed, then Islam will die. And that's why they're scared. They can't have any other faith coexist with them because they believe they're criminals. And Christians, you're not criminals. You are loved by Christ, and you will be saved as long as you endure up to the end. God bless you.
Amen.